Hey guys, in this week's video, we are going to talk about vitamin B12 deficiency symptoms. We're going to be talking about the signs and symptoms. We're going to be talking about what causes vitamin B12 deficiencies. We're going to be talking about how we actually diagnose it, and also vitamin B12 deficiency treatments, and also vitamin B12 boosting foods. So what foods should be eating? So stay tuned, we're gonna go through all of it. So welcome to my channel. If you haven't been here before, we talk about everything healthcare and medical here on the channel. And most importantly, all of the information that we give on the channel is always evidence-based. So you know you can trust the information that we're giving you. Also, please remember in all our videos, the whole video is chaptered in the description below. So if at any point you wanna find a specific piece of information, feel free to click on the description and click on that relevant chapter. However, as I always say, make sure you watch the whole video because it's gonna make you a bit of a pro at the end of it. Lastly, before we begin, if you find anything helpful in this week's video, please don't forget to click that like button because it's gonna help me and it's gonna help the video to grow to a much larger audience. Now, let's begin. Okay, so first of all, what is vitamin B12? Vitamin B12 is a nutrient that we all need to keep our nerve and body cells healthy and active. Now, if you've seen any of my other videos, which I do have a video on iron deficiency anemia, which obviously means a deficiency of iron. When we have B12 deficiency anemia, again, it basically means you have a deficiency of vitamin B12. Simple as that. Now, a long-term vitamin B12 deficiency can cause problems with our red blood cell size. You see, one of the things that B12 does is it actually regulates the size of our red blood cells. And if we don't have enough of it, our red blood cells can become really big. And this is known as megoblastic anemia, okay? Which basically means that they become really big, these blood cells, okay? Now, some people are more prone to becoming B12 deficient. Sometimes, again, it's just age that can cause it. But certain dietary requirements, like as in if you were like vegan, it can increase your risk of becoming B12 deficient. Also, certain medicines can increase your risk, and also if you drink a lot of alcohol, these can all increase your risk of getting a B12 deficiency. Now, without B12, we can have long-term problems as well, one of which is such as heart failure, as an increase in your risk of heart failure, and also another problem that you can get with B12 deficiency is nerve damage as well. Now, one of the main causes of B12 deficiency is caused by something known as pernicious anemia. And pernicious anemia is when our body doesn't create enough proteins, which are known as intrinsic factors in our stomach, that actually absorb and take in the B12. So basically, when we have pernicious anemia, we can't make these proteins that actually absorb this B12 in, okay? That means that if you have pernicious anemia and you take a B12 supplement, let's say for example, a tablet, you're not gonna absorb it. You are just gonna, it's just gonna go through your system and it's gonna be excreted, okay? So with pernicious anemia, the only actual treatment for it is an injection of vitamin B12, but we will go through that a little later on. So pernicious anemia is our main cause of B12 deficiency, but as I mentioned slightly just before it, certain other things can increase our risk as well. So for example, restrictive diets, if you're vegan or vegetarian, it can increase your risk of a B12 deficiency. Certain medicines, if you're taking them, for example, metformin, this can reduce the absorption of B12. There are other medicines as well that can potentially do this as well. Certain conditions such as IBD, such as Crohn's and colitis, these can cause malabsorption where we don't actually absorb enough of the nutrients and the vitamins that are needed. High alcohol intake, again, this can affect it as well, which again is gonna affect those intrinsic factors as the high alcohol and it's gonna stop it from absorbing. So these are the other factors that can actually cause a B12 deficiency, but pernicious anemia is probably the most common, but these lifestyle factors are also very important as well. Okay, so now that we're done with the basics and the science behind what is vitamin B12 deficiency, next thing we're gonna talk about are the signs and symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency. Okay, so you now have to remember, we spoke about the red blood cells being massive, and this basically means that they have a much larger, well, smaller surface area because they're so big. This means that they can carry less oxygen, and when we can carry less oxygen, it's gonna then result in some really telltale symptoms, which I've wrote down in typical Abraham Pharmacist style for you all that I love to do. So the first symptom is tiredness, okay? Tiredness is the most important thing, the main symptom that we're gonna get from vitamin B12 deficiency. Next, we've got lethargy. And lethargy is basically where you don't have the energy or you just can't really be bothered doing stuff, which you used to really, maybe really enjoy before as well, but you just don't have the energy anymore to do that. So that's lethargy. I guess they go hand in hand with tiredness. The other thing that sometimes people get is a headache. Again, remember, we're gonna be supplying less oxygen, so it is quite likely you'll get a headache. These symptoms usually all come together, by the way. You might also get a loss of appetite or indigestion, okay? Now, if anyone's getting these sort of symptoms, symptoms 4 and 5, loss of appetite or indigestion, and they're not getting these three, I'd be more concerned about that, to be honest, to speak to someone. And to be quite honest with you, if you're getting any of these symptoms, you need to speak to a healthcare professional. But if you're just getting the two of them and not the other three, then it might probably not be a B12 deficiency, but it's still really, really important to speak to a healthcare professional, because any loss of appetite or any indigestion and you haven't spoke to your healthcare professional about it can be a sign of other things. For example, the first thing that comes to my mind is, you know, cancer symptoms, and hopefully it will not be that, and I don't want to scare you all, but it's also not a joke, and we need to take these sort of symptoms seriously. But these are the main symptoms of a vitamin B12 deficiency: tiredness, lethargy, headaches, loss of appetite, and indigestion. Please remember those. And now we will move to the next scene. Now, as I explained, these are pretty general symptoms that we can all experience from time to time for a range of different reasons, a part of normal life, like working an extra shift, which causes tiredness, or and a headache, or eating too much spicy food and it might cause indigestion. But if and when these symptoms become long-term or severe, then you should definitely speak to your healthcare professional for advice. And as I explained earlier as well, if you're getting sort of loss of appetite or indigestion, anything like that, always speak to your healthcare professional. Now, with the B12 deficiency, as I explained earlier, we're going to be carrying less oxygen, so it is quite normal as well for you to be a lot more short of breath doing usual activities. You might also have pale skin, that can sometimes happen as well. You might also have a more rapid heart rate, and also feeling a bit dizzy sometimes, that can be quite normal as well. So those are the sort of symptoms to look out for as well. But please do remember, if you ever experience any chest pain with any of this, please call the emergency services straight away, whatever it is in your country, 999, 911, whatever it is, call them straight away, as it could be something else. Now, if you remember back to when I was talking about what B12 is responsible for, one of the things that vitamin B12 is massively responsible for is keeping our nerves nice and healthy and in working order. And one of the things that I see quite commonly in patients with vitamin B12 deficiencies is pins and needles, okay? So that loss of sensation. Again, this is due to that deficiency of B12, so the nerves aren't working right, and patients sometimes get a loss of sense and pins and needles, okay? Other things that they can get as well, because remember the nerve system is related, sometimes patients can get visual disturbances, sometimes they can also get memory problems or just forgetting things. So these are quite common. If you're getting any of these sort of symptoms, again, you need to speak to your healthcare professional. But again, remember, it could be a sign of a B12 deficiency if it goes hand in hand with the other symptoms that we've been speaking about. And other symptoms to be aware of, which are less common, but it's good to be aware of, with B12 deficiency, sometimes you can get increased mouth ulcers, you can also get a sore red tongue, and sometimes you can get a yellow tinge to your skin. I will leave all of these in the description below. Please remember, if you ever feel like you have a B12 deficiency and you're showing any of these symptoms, you need to speak to your healthcare professional. That is the most important thing, because remember when I said earlier about the causes, the main cause of a B12 deficiency is usually due to pernicious anemia, which is where we don't have those intrinsic factors to absorb it. So if you do have pernicious anemia and you think, oh, it's okay, I'll take a vitamin supplement, I'll take some B12 supplements, it's not gonna work because you're not gonna absorb it. Just like you're not absorbing it from your food, you're not gonna absorb those tablets. So you need to speak to a healthcare professional, because vitamin B12 is so vital for your body to function healthily. For your cells, for your nerve cells, they all need it. And I hope this all makes sense. Okay, so I hope you're finding this information helpful so far. If you found any of this information new, please don't forget to click that like button. It's gonna help me, and it's gonna help the video grow to a larger audience so more people can learn about B12 deficiencies. So the next thing I wanna talk about is, let's say you've gone to your surgery, you've gone to your healthcare professional, what are they gonna do? Well, they're gonna take a full history of you, find out what symptoms you're having, find out how long it's been going on for, check your lifestyle, check your diet, all these sort of things that we spoke about earlier. And they will do a blood test as well. Blood test is one of the most important parts, because they're gonna do a full blood count, they're gonna check your folate, they're gonna check your B12, and also they might check, you know, for your intrinsic factors as well to see if they're negative or positive, okay? So that's just a bit of a rough outline of what's gonna happen when you speak to your healthcare professional. Now, this type of blood test helps reveal a wealth of information on your blood cells, including their average size, the concentration of them in your blood, and how much hemoglobin they can carry. Although it's important to note that in some cases, even though you have a B12 deficiency, your B12 blood results may come back as normal. This is because most blood tests that are done on a routine basis are only able to measure the total amount of B12 in your blood. Now, this is quite rare, but it's important to remember because the B12 blood test cannot differentiate between the active and the inactive form. So let's say if you did a blood test and it's in a normal range, it might actually be in the abnormal range because we can't see how much of the active and inactive B12 you have in your blood. And conversely, you can also have a low B12 result, even if you're not actually deficient. Sometimes you see this in pregnant ladies or people taking a contraceptive pill. So what your healthcare professional will then do is use a range of different symptoms and history taking that they've done on you to see if you actually have a B12 deficiency or not. And it's also common practice for your healthcare professional to do other checks as well, especially if you're symptomatic, let's say, to do tests on your liver, to do tests on your thyroid, because all of these have very similar symptoms as well. So please bear that in mind as well. Don't be shocked if you're getting blood tests for your liver or your thyroid, even though you're thinking it might be a B12 deficiency. This is completely normal to be tested. Okay, so now let's move on to treatments of a vitamin B12 deficiency. So, in terms of treatments, we have two forms of medication that we can give, which is B12 basically. We've got tablet form, which is cyanocobalamin. That's the one that we prescribe here in the UK. And we also have the injectable form, which does come as cyanocobalamin, but here in the UK we give hydroxycobalamin because it usually lasts a bit longer. So that's the two forms. Now, please do remember, when you are getting prescribed a B12 supplement, let's say, whether it's a tablet or an injection, we really need to check for that pernicious anemia. I know I spoke about it a bit earlier, but please remember, if you have pernicious anemia and you're taking a B12 supplement as a tablet, you're not going to absorb it. Just like you're not absorbing it from your food, because you don't have those intrinsic factors to take in that B12, okay? It's just going to get excreted out. Therefore, if you have pernicious anemia, you will need an injection, whether it's hydroxycobalamin injection, an intramuscular injection, or a cyanocobalamin injection. That is what you will need, okay? Because the tablets just aren't going to do it for you. Also, please remember that when you have pernicious anemia, it is generally lifelong, so you will need to continue with the top-ups of the injections. But if your B12 deficiency is caused by dietary or lifestyle factors and you don't have pernicious anemia, which means that you have the intrinsic factors, most likely it will get treated with the tablet form of B12, and then afterwards your healthcare professional will advise you on lifestyle and diet just to keep your B12 at the level. Now, when it comes to foods that are rich in vitamin B12, good sources can be found in fish, eggs, meat, and dairy products. And if you follow a vegan diet, soy products, nutritional yeast, fortified cereals, and fortified breads are also options. Okay, so I really feel like we're getting somewhere now. We've spoken about B12 deficiency, why it happens, what it does, the signs, the symptoms of B12 deficiency, and the treatments. But please do remember, please do not avoid treatment if you have a B12 deficiency. It's really important that it's treated properly because the lack of B12 long-term can increase your risk of heart failure, it can cause brain problems, it can cause nerve problems, it can even cause an increased infertility, and even in pregnant ladies as well, it can cause problems for the baby in terms of their spinal cord and brain development as well. So B12 is a very important vitamin that we need. Okay, so when it comes to seeking medical attention, as I said earlier, if you think you have a B12 deficiency, you need to speak to your healthcare professional. It is so important because vitamin B12 is critical for so many things that we spoke about in this video. So if you think you have a B12 deficiency, if you have any of these sort of signs or symptoms, a box is going to be here for you. Pause the video. We've already gone through these signs and symptoms, but pause it now if you want and give it a read. If you think you have any of these symptoms, speak to your healthcare professional so they can do the correct history taking, examination, blood tests, everything they need to do to check what is causing it. That is the most important thing that you take home from this video. Please don't think you can just treat a B12 deficiency on its own, because you cannot, because if you haven't done a blood test to check for your intrinsic factors, it is completely pointless to take a B12 supplement. So please don't fall for what everyone's telling you. There's a lot of misinformation out there about this sort of stuff, but it's really important that you find out if you have pernicious anemia or not. That is the most important thing. Also, please do remember, if you are pregnant and you think you have a B12 deficiency as well, please, please, please speak to a healthcare professional. Again, it's really important that it's checked out and the levels are put into the correct range. So it looks like we've come to the end of this week's video. You are now a vitamin B12 pro. You now know all about what vitamin B12 does. You now know about the symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency, the signs. You now know about the treatments and when to seek medical advice. So you're a bit of a pro on it. So tell your friends, tell your family, tell your loved ones, tell whoever that you think might have a B12 deficiency. and tell them to go and speak to their healthcare professional. I really hope that you found this information helpful. If you've got any of your own kind of symptoms that you'd like to leave as well, leave it in the comments below. I'd love to read it, and I'm sure other people would love to read it too that might be able to relate to it. It'd be really helpful actually. As I always say at the end of every single video, please do always remember that you're awesome, and I'll see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.